Many, many congratulations. A fantastic performance out there. You've spoken already about your delight and your joy, but just try and put it into words what this afternoon has done for you.
Yeah, I wouldn't have expected this at all at the beginning of the week. I got off to a slow start and you know, there's really good players here this week, so to come out on top was just unbelievable, especially so early in my career. So I can't really put it in words at the moment, but if you ask me in a couple of days or a couple of weeks, I'll be able to answer it in better form.
It was, I mean, I presume you had a performance in mind when you went out there, but presumably this was it. I mean, it was just wonderful, wasn't it?
Yeah, my target at the beginning of the week was to get to 10 to 15 under. To reach 21 was excellent, and I would never have expected to have won. So I'm thrilled with everything I've done this week.
When did you think it was done in your way? I mean, I know you looked at the leaderboards. What did you think?
I thought I was going to... I don't know if I was going to win on 13 or not. You know, I hit a good putt on 14, and I saw the leaderboard and realised I was two behind, and I hit the green on 15, and two putted really good, and I held a really good putt at 16, and then I thought I was able to win. So I hit two great shots down 17 and two great putts, and you know, the last I played really well, so I'm just thrilled.
I was sitting with you when you were waiting. It was a slightly nervy wait, wasn't it?
Yeah, no, I didn't really know what was going on with the scores. There was a lot going on, so you know, to have come out on top at the end of the week, and was it three shots?
Two
shots. To win by two was great, and I'm thrilled to be a part of the European Tour.
That's great stuff. I'll take some questions, Norman, please.
I remember you saying only a few days ago that you'd like to do the same as Rory McIlroy did in 2007. What you've done it, can you just give us a few words?
Yeah, I know. It feels great. You know, Rory is a great player, and I'd love to be like him one day. And I'm just really happy I was able to win today. Like I said, I was never thought I was going to be able to do that. So to come out and win was just beyond my knowledge.
When you were sitting in the recorder's hut and the other scores were going through, was your first bit of elation thought, God, I'm certainly going to be second now, and that's no tour score?
I knew I wasn't going to tour score when George O'Grady came over and says, welcome to the European Tour. So I was thrilled when he said that, and you know, to have won was even better.
Yes, Graham.
Sorry, just carrying on. Your invitation next week's been withdrawn, you're in, but you've now got to get a visa for Shanghai. How are you going to do that?
I've got a good team around me. Adrian Mitchell, my manager, is a great guy, and from IMG, I'm sure they'll sort out wherever I can.
Two passports?
Not at the moment. Maybe.
Are you going home tonight?
Yeah.
Tom, I know it's still sinking in this week, but when you sort of talk about Rory winning before Rory McIlroy, and also he's won probably
quicker
than Tiger Woods ever done. When you sort of think about that, how do you sort of feel?
You know, I've got a long way to go. I'm nowhere near the player I want to be. So, you know, I'll put this win behind me, you know, at the end of the year and start fresh next year. So I'm really pleased.
Has Rory been one of your idols?
Definitely. You know, Rory has come up in my age, and you realise how good of a player he is and what people think of him. And you know, it'd be lovely to be like that one day, but I've got a long way to go.
One last question about Rory. What sort of relationship have you got with him?
He's a really nice guy, and that's what's most important. You know, a lot of the top guys are really nice, and they've been really nice to me. So it's been a really nice way of easing in and meeting them. So I'm really happy, and hopefully I can get to know him over the next couple of years more.
Joe,
did you think you could win before the year was over?
Yeah, I knew. You know, I played a couple of events as an amateur in a pro event over in Australia and in Dubai earlier this year, and I knew the standard was good, but I knew that I was able to win. I didn't have anything I didn't feel was weak enough. I wasn't able to win. It was just whether the nerves and the mind was able to carry on and realise that I was able to win. So.
Playing in the first round 65
year old
and playing with Tom Watson was a big
strain for him. Yeah, I think that gave me more confidence. It was just a one-off. I had three bad rounds after that, so it wasn't a great week other than the first round. but to have four great scores this week was even better.
Great.
In terms of your development, your father's obviously been a great influence, but I heard you say you've been with Pete Cowell for 6 years. How come you've been with Pete that long?
Well, the tournament director, Dave Williams, was actually the guy that introduced me to Pete, and I was able to get a lesson as when I was younger and continued with Pete over the years, and you know, he's done a great job with me.
And Williams, of course, is a very friend of your dad's, isn't he? So there must be a touch of
feeling there. No, it was really good to get presented with a trophy from David. He's a really nice guy, and he's helped me over the years. Not that high, but probably a bit taller. And you know, when I was about 10, I used to play golf with his daughter Lucy, who's a really good player. So you know, to have his help as well and all the knowledge from their past experiences on the tour is excellent.
Have you thought what you're going to spend
$400,000? I'm not bothered about the money at this moment in time. I'm just, you know.
You have a car?
I have a car, yeah.
What is it?
It's a Honda Civic.
Tom, can I ask you, does Tom wants to know how to get in touch with you?
Tom's been really nice though. He said that I'm welcome to go over to his house and practice anytime I like. And you know, I'm probably not going to take that up. That's a bit extreme. But he's been really nice, and I'm sure I'll come across him over the years.
I'm sure you'll hear from him pretty soon too, I think.
Sorry.
I'm sure you'll hear from him next day or two, I think.
You know, it'd be really nice, but you know, I'm sure he's really busy doing his own thing.
Going back to the Irish connection with Rory, can you talk a bit about Colin?
Colin was excellent. You know, without his help this week was, you know, it was just to have his experience was excellent. I don't think I thanked him in the speech, and I'm really gutted about that. You just reminded me. But hopefully I'll make up to him next week and try and maybe get another win. We'll just see how it is. But Colin's just a great guy, really down to earth, and I thank him for everything.
What did he say with you hanging over that second shot into the last? I mean, you have a perfect angle, but did you just say go for the middle of the green? Or
well, we had a similar line. He was going more right than I was. But I thought I was going to put it right anyway, so I aimed a little bit further left, but we're on the same wavelength half the time, so that helps a lot.
Do you by any chance know the Portuguese
amateur
that played quite
well here? Pedro's really good, yeah. You know, he's a really nice guy, and I've known him over the years. So I'm really thrilled that he played well this week, and that he'll come out in the next couple of years once he's finished university in America and hopefully do what I did and win an event, and hopefully in Portugal. I'm sure that would be his dream.
Have you spoken with him this week?
I've seen him over the past couple of days, but I haven't really had the chance to catch up with him.
Out of curiosity, what's some of the things you like away from golf?
I like spending time with my girlfriend. She's really nice, and her name's Lara. She caddied for me when I won once as an amateur this year. So she plays golf, so it's really good to have that connection, that she can understand what I'm going through, and that's great. And I spend time with her, and I play golf and have arguments with my dad. That's about it. I support Liverpool, so I heard they let in a late goal the other day, which was typical of them, and typical of Man United.
Think your board might go up now?
Sorry?
Think your board might go up. Your board at home,
you're paying
board at home?
No, I don't think so. I think I need a few more wins for that to happen.
Yeah.
Any more questions for Tom? I don't think so. Tom, as we said at the end, with the prize-giving ceremony, a star was born. I think that's true, and I think we all enjoyed watching it.
Well done. Thank you so much.